So the question for today is, how long will you live? So go ahead and put that down in the comment section. The oldest person documented that ever lived was Jeanine Calment. She lived to be 122. Now, currently, as of the 4th of January, 2021, the oldest living person is a woman living in Japan, and she's 118 years old. And the second oldest living person is 116 years old, a woman living in France. The third is 116 years old in Brazil. And then it goes down the list from there to 115, France, 115, Japan, 115, Brazil, 115, Brazil. And all the way down to number 49, we get a man who's 111 living in Spain. Now, what's interesting about this is the first 50 people are all women, okay? So women do live longer than men, about 7 to 8 years longer. Now, on average, in the US, men live to be 76.1 years, and women live to be 81.1 years. So to me, that's actually pretty young compared to these people over here. Now, I'm 55 right now. So if I live to the average number of years, I have 21 more years to go. That doesn't seem like a lot of time. But if I actually reach this goal right here, I have about 56 years to go, which is roughly at the halfway mark, which actually I like this one a lot better. So I am actively doing things every single day as far as diet and exercise and environmental things to extend my life because I want to be around as long as possible. So the question is, what are you doing right now that is extending your life? Are you eating correctly? Do you know what to eat? If you don't, I put a link down below. You can check it out. But getting back to why women live longer, there's three reasons. Number one, they have more estrogen than men, and estrogen can help express genes that make more antioxidants, which will help to counter free radical damage, which will lessen the damage to the DNA and the mitochondria, and they have less rates of getting cancer, etc. Number two, they have a better immune system than men. The immune system in a female ages slower, especially the T cells and the B cells. And on top of that, they have more killer T cells. So men need to work twice as hard to keep their immune system strong and realize that the immune system is not just about fighting pathogens and preventing infections. It's about killing cancer as well. So make note of that. All right, number three, women overall have a lower production of oxidants, those things that can cause oxidation of the cells and your mitochondria, which is the energy factory of the cells. In fact, they produce one half the hydrogen peroxide than men produce. And hydrogen peroxide is a very powerful oxidation compound that your body uses for fighting pathogens and other things as well. Also, women produce twice as much glutathione, which is a very powerful antioxidant, than men. So I have to work twice as hard as my wife to keep the oxidants low and the antioxidants very, very high. If you want additional tips on anti-aging, I put those links down below. Check them out. Before you go, if you have a question about a product or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.